Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this membership site build guide, you're going to learn how to use Thrive Apprentice from Thrive Themes to build a membership site on your WordPress site. Timestamp table of contents in the description, along with a link to a software review video that compares Thrive Apprentice to some other options if you're trying to figure out which solution is best for you to build your membership website. Here, we're just going to talk about how to put together Thrive Apprentice using Thrive Themes. There's also an affiliate link in the description if you want to learn more and actually purchase this plugin. So let's go ahead and jump right in here. The first thing I wanted to show you is what it looks like to the users when they're looking at your courses. So at the very top here, you have something called tags, which I'll get to later in this tutorial, where you can essentially organize your content. Then next, you'll have all of your different courses that are available, and inside your courses, when they click learn more or enroll now or start now, they'll be able to access all of their content. And so this is what a course homepage looks like, and you can create it so there's drop-down menus so they can get to all of their lessons. It's a very clean and nice layout. I really like how easy it is to set this up and the fact that this is all templated. So if you want to change how this looks and feels, you can change it from one location and it will update all of your courses. So that's what these individual pages look like. Let's go ahead and go into an actual lesson page. So you see at the top here, you can either have a video or you can have a cover image, whichever you prefer. And then underneath you can put all the content that you want. I'll show you how you can easily edit this. So that does it for going over what your students are going to see when they log into your membership site. Now on the back end here, this is what your Thrive Apprentice dashboard is going to look like. And of course you can access this by mousing over your Thrive icon and then clicking on Thrive Apprentice, and this is where you'll be taken. So here you'll be able to preview the index page, which is what we just talked about, set up your course topics, some advanced settings, and then of course create a new course. So let's go ahead and go through the settings here. So we'll click on template settings, and this is where you're actually going to be able to easily modify what your course page looks like and what your course index looks like. So over here, you can choose your fonts. You can change the color of your headlines. Now clicking on advanced settings, something that I do want to point out, and of course you want to do this before they have a demo mode, so you don't have to have a course published. And you definitely want to set this up and make sure it looks good before you dive into making all of your courses. So something that I actually did here, coming down to course structure, you can play with all this other stuff, but I actually clicked collapse modules and collapse chapters, because if you unclick this, then it's just going to be a long laundry list. If I go back to live, there we go, live version, you'll see that now all of the lessons and modules are just listed out on one page. It makes it really, really long, and I think not very user-friendly, so I go ahead and click on collapse chapters and menus and lessons, so that the modules here, they just have to click the little plus and then they can see all the submodules, and that way they can easily just click on the name of the module and then they'll get the list of all here. That way, especially if you have a lot of content on your membership website, you want to make sure that it's very user friendly. So now before we dive into actually creating a course and the dimensions you need for the images, there is a huge thing that you need to do, and that is making sure that you have all of your course content very detailed and organized in another location. So I'm going to walk you through a Google Doc that we've put together, and you want to do this because software changes, and we've learned the hard way that if you don't have everything meticulously organized off of your platform, it can be very painful to switch. So here's what our Google Doc looks like, so that if for whatever reason we needed to leave Thrive Apprentice, we could do so in less than a week. You can see here we have the module, we have the name in the description of the module, and then for each lesson we break down what the name, description, the type of lesson it should be, and then either the cover image or the link to the video. So if this was a paid course, this would be a Vimeo URL. I'll go through an example of one of our paid courses here. And then you just want to click what type of video settings you want, if you want the video to autoplay or not. And then all of the course content is actually just written out right here in this Google Doc. And if we go back to our course and scroll down, you'll see that the exact same content is here in the tabs. And I'll show you how to put together these tabs if you want to do that for your own membership website. Before we dive into the course, it's just really important that you have all of you, literally all of your information in some sort of document or organized folder, so it's very easy to switch and very easy for someone else to put it together. So I'm just scrolling here so you can see there's 31 pages of content in here, but this is our entire free Aspire Notebook membership course content so that it's very easy for us to switch should anything go wrong. So let's go ahead and go back to the Apprentice dashboard and actually create our course. Now, before I realize, let me jump back one real quick. Course topics, you can create topics, and this is how all of your courses are going to be organized. I highly recommend doing no more than 7 to 10 because you just don't want it to be overwhelming. These topics should be really broad, not specific, not like tags for the type of content that you have. So let's go ahead and click on Add New. So when you click on Add New, you come straight to the course details, and you'll be able to give your course a name and a description. And if you have a video that previews your course content, this is where you would drop in that video information. So if we go back to the live course here, and I go all the way back up to the Aspire Notebook level, you'll see that there's a video right here that pops up that's an intro to the entire course. That's what we're looking at adding here. Now, if you go down to advanced settings, you'll be able to choose your topic. You're going to choose whether or not you want comments. I typically leave comments off. And then difficulty level is also an optional thing. I personally don't normally use it. And then of course your bio, if you don't want your WordPress bio being pulled in, or you don't even know what your WordPress bio is, then just go ahead and click on custom bio and you can easily put in your about you right here and remove the image or change the image. So your bio is actually what's going to show up all the way at the bottom right here. And this will show up on every page on your membership site. And of course you probably want to restrict your access if you're doing a paid membership, so you can go ahead and click on this, and then whatever membership plugin you're using to handle your payments and membership levels should show up right here, and you'll be able to click on whichever level it applies to. And of course, if you're not seeing what you need, then you need to go over to whatever membership plugin software, protection software that you're using to set up those. So I typically recommend trying something like MemberPress or MemberMouse to manage your actual payments and restriction of the content. Thrive Apprentice is great for organizing all your content, but it falls pretty much flat on its face if you're trying to protect and collect payments for your products. And once you've filled all this out, you can go ahead and click Save. So I'm going to go back to the dashboard to go through a actual example, one that's already made, to save us some time. You can always click on course details here to get the exact same menu and restrict access if you need to change anything. This is free, so there's no restrict access on this one. Now with the modules, it's very easy to add and subtract content with Thrive Apprentice. So what's really nice is when we went through putting together your template, once you have that template, it will apply to everything that you put together. So you're not gonna have 30 new pages show up inside of your WordPress dashboard when you click on pages. These are all going to be inside of Thrive Apprentice, but you still can use something called Thrive Architect, which is a drag and drop page builder to modify the pages individually if you want. So if you want to be more custom, you can. If you just wanna get it done as quickly as possible, you can also do it that way. So now that we have our module, let's go ahead and add a new lesson. So we'll go ahead and give our lesson a name and a description, and then we'll click on the type of lesson it is. If it's a text, audio, or video. In this particular instance, it's a video, and we're using a YouTube video, so I'll go ahead and drop in that YouTube URL and click on Save. So of course, it's not actually published yet. That's why it's in red. And then we can go ahead and edit with Thrive Architect, or we can publish the lesson, or if we click on here, we can click on the three little dots and click edit content to get back to this page. So I'll go ahead and hit save again. And before we publish the lesson, let's go ahead and edit it using the drag and drop Thrive Architect Builder. So this is going to allow you to modify all of the content that comes below the video. So you can see here, we have the video that we chose in the lesson settings. We have our headline, and now we can actually modify all of this blank space. So to do that, we'll come over here to this plus button to add an element. And the first thing we're going to do is just add a little text box. Click and drag it over and drop it in. And now we have all of the space in the world to just type some random stuff.
Now, something that I really like doing is tabs. So I'll click and drag these tabs over and put it above the box. And I like using this element because it's a really easy way to organize a lot of content without having the page super, super long. So I'll just have like an overview, a place for their downloads, some additional resources, and then recommended software or recommended tools if you want to integrate some affiliate links. So it's a really great way to organize a bunch of content and have it readily available to people while they're watching the video up top, and they can just click through the tabs as opposed to scrolling down a really long page. And of course, you can change all of the colors and the settings and the formatting of these tabs. So once we're done, we'll go ahead and click save and exit, and we'll be able to preview what we've put together. So here's a preview. They can just click and the YouTube video will start playing. I'll go ahead and pause that there. And then they have tabs that they can go through to get all of their content. Now let's go ahead and go through an actual live one so you can see what this looks like all put together. So inside of the Aspire notebook, I'll scroll down and click on team, and I'll get to the cover images in a second here. And scrolling down here, we'll click on the first lesson under the team module. And you'll see here we have our YouTube video, we have tabs that are full of the content, and a handy little link down here that users can click to go on to the next lesson and get their content. So you can see the difference between using tabs and then just having a bunch of text. We just did a bunch of text here because we hardly had any content, but I do like, especially for paid courses, having tabs, because you can see this doesn't look as put together or as professional as those tabs. Now, the final part of putting together your course is creating some nice looking cover images for not only the course, but also your modules. And then if you're doing text lessons, you're going to want a image that shows up where the videos were showing up. And you can use a free tool called Canva to do this. So the dimensions you need for your cover image inside of Thrive Apprentice is 1170 by 400. So if we jump on over to Canva, you can see a couple of examples here of what cover images look like for the actual courses and then for the modules. So you can see here, this is the team cover we put together for the Aspire Notebook. So if we go over to the Aspire Notebook team, you'll see this is where the image shows up. And of course, you'll have to play a little bit with the spacing because you don't want to actually put things directly in the middle. It's like three or four key arrow keys up, but I'll let you play with that because it can be frustrating. But once you get it down, you'll have the template and it'll be very easy to use. So let's go through actually adding one of these to a current course that I already have on the site. So if I go back to the course index here, you can see here the Authority Builder course doesn't have a cover image. So let's go ahead and fix that and go back to the Thrive Apprentice dashboard. So I'll go to the Authority Builder course and go to course details. And you'll see right here, I can click to upload a cover image. So I'll go back over to Canva, and this is the cover image we just put together. So I'll go ahead and download it. And just like that, we have our cover image. So let's go back to the dashboard here and click to upload. We have a new file, so we'll just go ahead and click and drag. Should probably rename this so that it's easier to find in the future. But we'll just kind of go fast here and we'll click on use the image we just uploaded. We'll click save, and now we'll go preview our course and of course index so we can see the cover image. And now you can see the cover image is here, and you can see that it's a little cut off. So it probably spent another 30 to 40 minutes playing with it so that it gets just enough so you can actually see the whole screen. But if we go ahead and click on start now, you'll be able to see that now the cover image shows up at the top of the course as well. And something that's different about this course is if we click on the first module here, you'll see that we actually created a cover image for each module and part because there were a lot of videos. So if you scroll down, we just embedded the videos right here on the page instead of having just one video at the top because there was a lot of content. So that's another thing that you can do. And inside the Authority Builder settings, just want to show you under restricted access here, if we scroll down, you see Authority Builder has been clicked. And so that is telling MemberPress that only people who've purchased Authority Builder will have access to this course. And so that's all there is to it, to building your course using Thrive Apprentice. So if you have any questions putting together your membership website, make sure you drop them in the comment section below. And if you have any feedback on using Thrive Apprentice, go ahead and drop it in the comment section below because your comments and questions are going to help other people figure out how to put together their membership website. And of course, remember that putting together
all of your course content and organizing it inside of a Word doc, spreadsheet, Google Doc, folder, whatever it may be, to ensure that it's very easy for you to switch platforms in the future is going to save you a lot of time and headache. So go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth tutorials just like this one over on the channel. I'm documenting the entire process of what it takes to build successful online course sales funnels. And of course, choosing the platform to host your online course is just one small piece of the bigger picture. So until the next video, keep building the business you love.